Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we will see how to turn an image into these pixelated effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. And as you can see, these are other examples I created using the same technique. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so I will go ahead and open Photoshop and I will take the image I will be using and open it in here. Now I need to cut the model from this background. But since we have a light gray background, almost white, it would be perfect to apply a level adjustment layer just to make it easier for me to create a selection. So I will go to adjustment down here and I will choose levels. I will darken the midtones by taking this slider and pull it around here. As you can see, this will make the whole image darker. So I will take the white and I will increase it a little bit, just to make the background whiter, and this way it will be easy to select. Alright, now we'll make sure that I'm selecting the level adjustment layer, and then I will choose the magic wand tool right here, and I will one click on this background to load the selection of the car white only. And now we have the background selected. But I need to invert it, this way I will have a selection of the model only. So I press Ctrl Shift I on my keyboard, or you can go to select and choose inverse right here. And I can delete this now. Alright, now we'll open the select and mask. This would be the refined edge in case you are using an older version of Photoshop. I will select the refined brush, and then I will start to improve the selection of the hair. And I will press OK. Now I will one click on this layer mask icon to apply my selection, and I will convert it to smart object. So I will right click and choose convert to smart object right here. Alright, now we create a new document. So I will go to file and choose new. In the width in here I have 1920 pixel, and the height 1080 pixel, 300 in the resolution, and RGB in the color mode. And I will click OK. Alright, now we'll take the model image and I will move it to the other tab using my move tool. I will press Ctrl T to scale it a little bit. I'm holding Alt and Shift on my keyboard to keep the image proportion, and I will place it right in the middle in here. And I will hold Shift to make it a little bit bigger, just around here. And I will click on this check mark to commit the change. Alright, now we'll select the background layer. I will double click on it. This window will pop up because the layer was locked. So we name it BG for background, and I will click OK to unlock it. I will go back to the background layer and I will double click on it to open the layer side dialog this time. I will select the gradient overlay and I will open the gradients in here. I will double click on this color stop and I will choose a soft gray color like this, and I will click OK. And then I will double click on the other color stop in here, and I will choose a very light gray color like this, and I will click OK and OK. Next, I will change the gradient size to radial and the scale to 120% and the angle to 135, and I will click OK. Alright, now we'll make two copies of the model layer. So I press Ctrl J two times, 1, 2, and I will name them Pixel 1, Pixel 2, and Pixel 3. Alright, now we'll hide the Pixel 3 and 2 layers for now, and I will select Pixel 1 layer. I will hold Alt and I will one click on this layer mask icon to apply a black layer mask, as you can see. And then I will open the properties panel. If you can't find it, just go to window and click on properties. Alright, now we'll put down the density of the layer mask a little, until I can see a bit of the model like this. Now I will select the brush tool, and then I will one click on this drop down to open the brushes. And I will one click on this gear icon right here, and I will choose a basic brush. I will press OK so I can replace my current brush. Now I will go back to the gear icon again, and this time I will choose square brush. But this time I will click append so I can add them to my current brush. As you can see, we have now the basic and square brushes together. Alright, now we select one of the square brushes, and then I will open the brush presets. If you can't find it, just go to window again and one click on the brush right here. Or you can use the keyboard shortcut F5. Alright, I will change the spacing around 120% And then I will select Shape Dynamics, and I will make the size jitter 100%. Alright, next I will go to Scaling. I will put a check mark on both axes, and then I will change the scatter to 1000%, and I will close it. Alright, now we'll make sure that the opacity and flow is set to 100%, and with white as my foreground color, I will start brushing like this, right in the center in here. I'm using the right and left bracket to make the brush smaller or bigger. Alright, just to get something like that. Now, while I'm still on the layer mask, I will open the properties panel again, and I will bring back the density to 100%. Alright, now we select the pixel tool layer and make it visible. And then I will go to filter, and I will choose liquify. I will select the freeze mask tool right here, and then I will brush over here to freeze this area. This way I can apply the liquify filter without affecting this freezed area in here. Now I will select the forward warp tool in the top in here, and then I will warp this part like this. And I will click OK. Alright, now we'll apply a black layer mask by holding the Alt key again and one click on this layer mask icon. And again, I will open the properties panel to bring down the density a little bit so I can see where I want to brush exactly. Alright, now we start brushing using the same custom square brush. Just to get something like this. Now I'll open the properties panel again and I will bring back the density to 100%. Alright, now we select the pixel 3 layer and I will make it visible. And then I will apply a white layer mask this time by one click on this layer mask icon without holding any key. And then I will open my brushes from here, and I will choose a regular square brush with black as my foreground color. I will start brushing to the leads from the edges by just clicking like this. Alright, just to get something like that. Now I will go to filter, filter gallery, and in the texture folder right here, I will open it and choose patchwork. I will put 4 in the square size and 6 in the relief. But feel free to change these numbers to get different results. And I will click OK. Now we'll select this white smart filter layer right here. And then I will open my brushes, and I will choose one of these basic rounded brushes. I will change the opacity to 70%, and with black as my foreground color, I will start brushing to delete the patchwork filter from here, but I will keep a little bit on the edges, just to create that pixel transition look. Alright, now we create a new folder on top, and I will name it Adjustment. This folder is optional, you don't have to create one too. I just like to make it, this way I can see the before and after the adjustments. Alright, now we'll add a gradient map from here. And then I will change the opacity first to 50% and the blending mode to lighten. Now I will one click on this gradient. You will find a link in the description where you can download these gradients I have in here. Just one click on this gear icon and choose replace gradients and load them. Alright, I will pick this one right here and I will click OK. Now I will add another gradient map from here. Again, I will change the opacity to 50% and I will change the blending mode to soft light this time. Next, I will one click on the gradient and choose another gradient. I will pick this one right here and I will click OK. Alright, now we'll add a level adjustment to play with the color in the channels. So I will go to the channels and choose the red channels to adjust the output levels. So I will go to the white slider right here and I will move it a little bit. And then I will go to the black slider and I will move it a little bit too. Alright, now we select the blue channel and I will do the same thing. And since it's an adjustment layer, I can always go back and change it if I didn't like it. Now I will go to adjustments and choose exposure. I will increase the offset a little bit and I will decrease the gamma correction. Alright, let's see now. This is before and this is after. And that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. If you like this video and want more tutorials like this, make sure to subscribe, leave a thumb up and share it, and have a nice day.